It is honorable when we treat the poor person with respect because he suffers and struggles in ways that perhaps we will never know. He is among us as a messenger from God to test our justice and our charity, allowing Jesus himself to live and love through us. Blessed Frederick Ozanam. God's blessing and peace upon you, friends. Thank you for joining us today in prayer. And during the month of September, we're taking random Wednesdays and highlighting various groups of those men and women around the world who live by the rule or spirit of St. Vincent de Paul, whose feast, of course, we're celebrating at the end of this month. So this month of September, Spirit of Vincentian Spirituality, today we talk about and break open a bit one of those groups. It's called the Society of St. Vincent de Paul, the largest lay group of charity in the world. It's amazing. Many Catholic churches have a what's called a conference or a group of the Society of St. Vincent de Paul, all because a young man named Frederick Ozanam, a college student a couple hundred years ago, was inspired by St. Vincent de Paul and wanted to help the poor, like he did, but Frederick didn't feel called to be a priest. So with a daughter of charity as his mentor, he just organized a group of friends to reach out and to do service, charitable acts for the poor. Well, others soon joined, and well, God took it, blessed it, and made it into something truly unbelievable today. So today, Frederick Ozanam, he is a blessed in the Catholic Church, which is one step towards being a saint. We're blessed today to have the national president of the Society of St. Vincent de Paul offer our reflection. Thank you for being here, friends. This is the God Minute, and I'm Father Ron Hoy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips.
And my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 25. Don't fail me, Lord. Forever I will lift up my soul into your presence, O Lord. Be there for me, God, for I keep trusting in you. Don't allow my struggles to overtake me or the shame of defeat. For how could anyone be disgraced when they've entwined their hearts with you?
Lord, direct me throughout my journey so I can experience your plans for my life. Reveal the life paths that are pleasing to you. Escort me along the way. Take me by the hand and teach me.
For you are the God of my increasing salvation. I have wrapped my heart into yours. Forgive my failures and overlook the sins of my immaturity. Give me grace, Lord. Always look at me through your eyes of love and compassion.
When you think of me, see me as one you love and care for. How good you are to me. When someone turns to you, they discover how easy you are to please, so faithful and true beyond comprehension.
Joyfully you teach me the proper path, even when they go astray. Keep showing the humble your path. May they obey you and follow you in the pleasant paths of love and faithfulness.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
Hi, my name is Ralph Middlecamp. I live in Madison, Wisconsin, and I am the president of the National Council of the Society of St. Vincent de Paul. What an honor it is to be with you in prayer at the God Minute. Father Ron asked me to share a few minutes about my own story and what the Vincentian spirit means to me.
Like many people, I joined the Society of St. Vincent de Paul because I wanted to put my faith into action. I wanted to live out Matthew 25 or to understand what it meant to be the Good Samaritan. And like many of us, I'd volunteered for many organizations over the past years. But when I joined the Society of St. Vincent de Paul, I discovered that it was about more than just serving people. I learned that it was a society that emphasized spiritual growth through this service. It emphasized doing it with friends, not just yourself. And it was a society that really focused on being the face of Christ to the people we serve, but maybe even more important, that they would be Christ to us. And so it's been a long journey together with friends in the Society of St. Vincent de Paul. And it's a society that we can learn not just from our fellow people in our councils and conferences, but we look back to the example of St. Vincent de Paul, Louise de Marillac, Frederick Ozanam, Sister Rosalie Rondeau, and many other people that came before us, because they walked the same journey that we walked. The challenges that Vincent had, that Frederick Ozanam had, aren't all that dissimilar to what I experience as I try to help people, as I face systems that may be unjust or systems that set people back rather than move them forward. And so the wisdom we have in writing from these people who came before us really are able to nurture us, and we're able to pray with them. Frederick Ozanam was very aware that to have St. Vincent de Paul as a model really provided both someone who could pray for us, but also someone who could be an example for us as we live this life. So I hope that all of the Vincentian family find support in each other, that those who enter a vocation of service to the poor can grow in holiness, that they grow in friendship, and that they constantly look to do service that lifts people up. And finally, we all need to see Christ in the people that we find, be they our family, the people we serve, the people in our churches and parishes. That's the challenge we all face as we live out this gospel calling.
And with your brothers and sisters all over the world praying with you, we together lift our voice and pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
And let us pray. O Lord, you raised up Blessed Frederick as someone blazing with the spirit of your love so that he could encourage a group of lay people in helping the poor. Help us, following his example, to carry out your commandment of love and become like yeast in the mixture of all those we will meet this day. We ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessings upon all of you today joining us. And Ralph, thank you in a special way for your own sharing and your love of the Vincentian life and work. Such great stuff you do. Thank you. Hey, and friends, on our blog, you can look at about a four-minute video that just describes and talks about the history of the Society of St. Vincent de Paul, how it started, Frederick Ozanam and the rest. It's only a few minutes, but it's really worth it, I think. It's just go to the blog, just go to our app homepage, tap blog, and you'll see it. God bless you all. May God's peace wrap you in his love in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Frederick Ozanam.
Pray for us.
St. Vincent de Paul.
Pray for us.
We'll see you tomorrow.